Oh, should I niche down? I'm gonna tell you the answer right here in this video. Stay tuned. Okay, it's rap pack to my pulse flat. We keep it real, no false rap. I got four cars and they all black. Got four bras and they all that. We call that ballin'. Doing this. So I get a lot of questions about niching down. Should you do it? Should you not do it? Should you niche up? Should you niche down? How should you do it to grow your business, to start your business? And what is the best strategies for niches? And it's very simple. I'm going to tell you, at the start, you need to be niching down. It's going to be a lot easier at the beginning to have that irresistible offer that people feel stupid trying to refuse. I think you should go into a niche because I have seen it work time and time again. My parents run an accounting firm, and I've seen it throughout my whole life, the niches that they have inside of their accounting firm that help to actually find their target audience. It's really hard to define your target audience if you're just a real estate agent or if you're just a lawyer. If you can actually target a specific group of people that's very specific, it's going to be a lot easier for people to see you as special, different, or the one. Now, if you didn't have a positioning statement already in place, I would highly recommend you start there. That's an easy way for your branding to identify a target market. When you go through a positioning exercise, if you go through it with a professional, which I highly recommend you do, you will notice that there is one group of people more than another. Typically, you'll realize there's one group of people that are better than another group. And this is the client that I feel excited to get on the Zoom call with them. So you're going to take that client and you're going to actually transform that into a model of here's our target client. After you come up with that target client model, then you can go through and identify, okay, who is my target market? So a niche doesn't just have to be for accountants or for lawyers or for real estate agents or for fitness coaches. It should be very specific. For example, I know a fitness coach who works specifically with single mothers to identify their problems and help them as they go through life. The goal is not to attract everyone, it's to attract the right people. This can be very helpful for him. When somebody comes to his website and sees his fitness coaching business, they're going to know if that product is for them or not. If they're a single mom, then that product is going to be for them and they're probably a lot more likely to buy. If that product is not for them, well, let's just say they're a dad with a happy wife and happy family, they're going to know that product just isn't for them. Now, it's going to be a lot easier to deliver on this service as well because you're going to become an industry specialist. If you can learn everything there is to know about what single mothers go through, you're going to be a lot better off in that space. Especially if you're offering a service, you are going to have a much easier time delivering because you are going to be able to know their exact pain points before you even hop on the call. The sales process is going to be very simple. You're going to be able to identify their pain points. You're going to be able to know what they need and know why you're special, different, or the one. And being able to articulate that to a client is just invaluable. So the answer, I think you should definitely niche down to start. But as that market grows and you become that industry leader, start to niche up a little bit. It can never hurt to start small, especially if your audience is good. Now, make sure that your audience, your small niche, is actually qualified. Meaning, do they actually have the money to go through and do your program? Because oftentimes that can be a huge, huge stopper of business to business consumers. So if you found any value in this show, make sure you share the show. I don't run ads on the show or for the show. So this is my raw opinion and I'm not sponsored by anybody. So I'd really appreciate it if you shared the show because I poured my heart and soul into this. I record multiple episodes every single day and I post at least one episode a day of this podcast. So I'd really appreciate it if you shared the show. Until next time, I'll see you tomorrow on another episode of Ugly Digital. It ain't all about the money, but I